Johannes Brahms spent three consecutive summers during the late 1880s vacationing in the small Swiss town of Thun. Something about its atmosphere and environment served as a powerful stimulus to his creative impulse. During those years, Brahms composed some of his most heartfelt and personal works, among them the violin and piano sonatas in A major and D minor, the F major cello and piano sonata, and the C minor trio for violin, cello, and piano. Why this outpouring of music for the violin? One answer, unquestionably, lies in the friendship, renewed at that time, between Brahms and Joseph Joachim, the distinguished violinist and conductor. A decade earlier, these two had been on close terms. Brahms composed his violin concerto for Joachim, and it was Joachim who was the soloist when the concerto was given its premiere, with Brahms himself conducting at a New Year's Day concert in Leipzig in 1879. But in the intervening years, Joachim became embroiled in a bitter divorce proceeding. A letter from Brahms that completely refuted some of Joachim's charges against his wife was introduced in court and opened a gulf between the two friends that was years in the bridging. Finally, by 1886, Joachim and Brahms were reconciled. The following summer in Thun, Brahms composed a strange hybrid of a work, a concerto for violin, cello, and orchestra. Brahms conducted the premiere of the piece. It was given in Cologne in October 1887. The soloists were Joachim and another friend of Brahms, a cellist named Hausmann. When the music was published the following year, Brahms presented the score to Joachim, and on it was the inscription, "To him for whom it was written." The double concerto was to be Brahms' last orchestral score. During the final decade of his life, he composed some chamber music and some songs, and the autumnal quality of these works is a characteristic of the double concerto as well. The concerto is in three movements, and the writing for the two solo instruments is a matched discourse of perfect fusion. Here are our soloists: concertmaster Elliot Chapeau, principal cellist Lorne Monroe, with our conductor Pierre Boulez, and with the New York Philharmonic, Boulez conducting, Elliot Chapeau and Lorne Monroe soloists, we'll have the double concerto for violin, cello, and orchestra by Brahms. Thank you.
Thank you.
The Double Concerto in A Minor for violin, cello, and orchestra by Johannes Brahms. The New York Philharmonic playing under the direction of Pierre Boulez with Elliot Chapeau, the orchestra's concertmaster, as the violin soloist, and Lorne Monroe, the orchestra's principal cellist, as the solo cellist. And the two of them have been recalled. Arm in arm, they bow. And now Mr. Chapeau reaches over and shakes the hand of Frank Galino, the orchestra's associate concertmaster. I'm reminded that there was a great recording of the Brahms Double Concerto by the Philharmonic made during the period when Bruno Walter was a regular conductor of the New York Philharmonic. The soloists in that recording were Isaac Stern and Leonard Rose, himself a former solo cellist of the New York Philharmonic. Pierre Boulez and our two soloists, Elliot Chapeau and Lorne Monroe, have once again returned to the front of the stage. The audience assembled here in Avery Fisher Hall, most warmly applauding this performance of the Double Concerto in A Minor for violin, cello, and orchestra by Brahms.